All right, everyone, are you ready for the second animal in our Two Truths and a Lie book from our library? This one is the tiny guardians of your bookshelf. Imagine you could shrink yourself down right now, zip, and slip into a book. Not actually falling into a story, like the kids who were sucked into Narnia through a painting in The Voyage of the Dawn Treader, but squashing yourself down to, say, the size of this capital letter B, and then going for a stroll across the pages of one of those dusty old books in your grandfather's library. If you did this, you might find yourself in the path of a very startling creature. Meet the book scorpion, better known as the house pseudoscorpion or Chelifer cancroides. These microscopic arachnids look a lot like regular scorpions, with eight legs and two long front-reaching pincers. But there are two big differences. First, book scorpions have no stinging tails. And second, they are teeny tiny, unless you're shrunk down to their size, of course. A third of an inch is as big as they're ever going to grow. And why do you suppose they're called book scorpions? Well, they love books, of course. Book scorpions can sneak into your library in many ways, but one of their favorite methods is playing tag-along. The tiny pseudoscorpion clings to the leg of a fly or other insect, then drops off when indoors. Once the book scorpion reaches a bookshelf, its hunt for food begins. The tiny predator is not too picky. Dust mites, moth or beetle larvae, and, drumroll please, book lice. What are book lice, you ask? They are insects, even tinier than book scorpions, that devour books. Specifically, book lice love to eat the starchy glue that holds old books together. So, like the excellent bookshelf guardians they are, book scorpions come along and eat the book lice before the book lice can eat your books. Gulp. Yum. Phew. Pseudoscorpions have been around a long time. They were mentioned in the writings of the philosopher Aristotle, who lived way back around 300 BCE. Still, most people today have never heard of them. For one thing, they are timid creatures and spend most of their time lurking out of sight. And of course, they're as small as the words printed on this page. You might walk by there, and there's a picture of one. Hiding spots every single day and never get a glimpse. Unless you were the right size, of course. Then you'd be able to meet and get to know this fascinating creature, your bookshelf's very own guardian and defender. That is the bookshelf scorpion. What do you think? Truth or lie? We'll have one more video and then you'll need to make a decision.